Genshin Impact has some amazing environments to experience. Even if, like most open world exploration games, it gets a little bit samey at times, once you get high up enough, there are some spectacular views. But just how high can you go? This video will show you the highest point in Genshin, how to get there, and the achievement you'll get for doing so. The mountain called Qingyun Peak is in Liyue, so you'll need to have done a little progression first before tackling this. Also note, this is a lot easier to do if you have a high stamina gauge, so find those ammonoculi and joculi where you can. The major benefit to doing it, however, is, bar the lovely view, you'll be able to glide very long distances. Plus, you'll get a statue of the Seven along the way. On the far western side of Liyue, you'll see a statue of the Seven waypoint. This one is called Minlin Liyue and is more or less on Qingyun Peak itself. It's going to take you some time to trek there, but be on your way over. As you get closer, the statue looks impossible to get to. It's on a floating rock. How are you meant to make your way there? Simple. In a manner of speaking, you climb there. There's a mountain to the immediate southeast of the statue point. Here's where your extra stamina comes into play. Climb up that mountain. At the top, you're going to see a statue of a divine bird, but for now, let's ignore that. The leap looks long, but you'll be able to glide over and activate the statue. You'll see a lot of travel waypoints to acquire as a result of this too, which you'll be able to easily glide to and activate later. Head back to that bird statue, and you can turn it by activating it. Rotate it so it's facing the tall mountain to your north, and wait a couple of seconds. A cutscene will play, releasing energy from the statue into the peak above. We're headed there next. Ascend that very tall mountain. Seriously, it's really, really tall. If you're having trouble, look for places up the mountain that look like you can stand on them to recover your stamina. There's a travel waypoint up there too. Don't miss that, as it's amazingly useful to teleport back here for easy gliding. Get to the top and activate the statue there. It'll tell you there's three divine bird statues to activate. And if you look around, you'll see little shining indicators for the remaining two places on other mountains. Glide over to those peaks, climb them, and turn their bird statues to be facing the original tall mountain. Once all three are rotated and you've seen the cutscenes, head back over and activate the statue again. This will activate an Ameno tunnel to take you even higher. Glide up that tunnel and you'll see three floating rocks. Jump onto those and you'll see yet another Ameno tunnel. Glide up that, four more floating rocks later, and you'll see the Overlooking View achievement appear, and that's it. You've climbed Qingyun Peak and you're at the highest place in Genshin. There's three chests here and a small story you can read about the origin of that floating rock. One of these chests contains a recipe for Adeptus's Temptation, a 5-star rarity food that grants attack and critical rate for your entire party for 5 minutes at a higher rate than the jade parcels you get via story progression. You can climb the wooden posts on the island and hop on the roof if you want to be at the truly highest point. Don't forget about the existence of photo mode in the main menu. Sit back, enjoy the lovely music Liyue has, and admire the view. Eh, why not? Jump and see where you land. Glide and enjoy slowly declining through the sky. Hope this little exploration guide helped. Comment with other challenges on Genshin you might need a hand on, and I'll make some videos for them. Subscribe for more content for Genshin and other weeb stuff that I do. And until the next video, or livestream, mata ne!